I am Marc, and today I have something to read for your kids and yourself. The Three Investigators and the Mystery of the Stuttering Parrot by Robert Arthur. I know that is something completely different from my other books that I had in my videos before, but that actually brings us to the middle of my childhood. And tips to encourage your kids to read are also important, I guess. Well, I read the books as well as listened to the radio plays, and I always was astonished by the stories about Jupiter, Pete and Bob, the three investigators. And today I'm going to introduce you to one of the volumes. But what is this book about? The three young detectives are supposed to look for an escaped parrot. Doesn't sound like an exciting case, I know. But suddenly, other people also seem to be interested in the parrot. But not because he says Latin sayings for the best. The three investigators have to use their brains quite a bit in that one. Jupiter, Pete and Bob discover that a mysterious Englishman has died, leaving seven parrots behind. Each of them can speak, one even stutters, and each of them is trained to utter cryptic messages. A sinister man tries so desperately to get hold of the parrots that he threatens anyone who gets in his way. But what did the Englishman want to say with his birds? Why does the Darkman want them? Well, the three investigators are determined to find out, hopefully before anyone gets hurt. In the USA, the series comprises a total of 58 volumes by 11 authors, published from 1964 to 1990 in three series by Random House. There are also two episodes with the first publication in German translation and also an unfinished episode. The series was created in the early 1960s by journalist and author Robert Arthur. He was convinced that, thanks to his experience in the mystery area, he could write better children's books on this subject than any other author of children's books. He also knew Alfred Hitchcock personally, and then came up with the idea of winning him over as a patron and editor of this series. For a while, it was mistakenly believed that Hitchcock was the series writer. In reality, Arthur had only been licensed to use Hitchcock's name and likeness. Hitchcock's foreword was not written by Hitchcock himself either, but was written by Arthur. Hitchcock himself never wrote the series or anything in it. On September 24th in 1964, Arthur's first detective novel appeared under the series title Alfred Hitchcock and the Three Investigators. After the employment in the United States, the German translator wanted to come up with their own stories in 1993. It's also being successfully produced as a radio play series. There are some notable differences between the original American editions and the German translations. On the one hand, the characteristic appearance of the black hardcover bindings, and also the fact that the title of the series was not translated literally as the three detectives, but as the three question marks. That's how I lived with it in my childhood. Everyone knows them here like that. The reason for the name change was that the publisher did not like the literal translation. Instead, they were guided by the symbols of the three detectives, the question marks. These were often used by the three for chalk markings. Since every detective has his own color, these are clearly recognizable. In addition, the question marks were also printed on their business card, which is quite often in the book. Jupiter is white, Pete is blue, and Bob is red. Also, there was a change compared to the American original, because there the chalk colors are white, blue and green, not red. In the text of the German translations, there are always small inserts with tips and hints from the fictional author Alfred Hitchcock, which should stimulate the reader to think. They are missing in the original American editions and have been supplemented by the translator Leonore Puschert. And some personal names also differ. In Germany, Justus Jonas is originally called Jupiter Jones, and Peter Shaw, as he's called in Germany, is called Pete Crenshaw. The two Irish brothers, Kenneth and Patrick O'Ryan, are called Hans and Konrad Schmidt in the original series and come from Bavaria. The chauffeur, Morton, is originally called Worthington. They are books for children and young people, but my generation here in Germany grew up with their radio plays and the books. And to be honest, when I relax between appointments on the bus and train, I still from time to time listen to one or the other radio play by the three investigators, or sorry, the three question marks, the drei Fragezeichen, as it is in German. I really love that, and I think it was well known in the US. It is still a big thing in Germany. That's why the series is still going on with German authors now. And I don't know how big that ever was in Ireland or the UK or in Australia or in any other part of the world. Please let me know if you ever heard about them before. And I'll see you in my next video. Bis gleich.